Let's go, one more try. That's a good start. We couldn't put a sled through the snow. Southpaw.
The answer is no. It does smell too good in there.
My light. Oh, where's my light? It's so dark in here. But you're really glad I'm into the cold bit.
Thank you, dear, for
bringing me
into a fridge.
These fires. So they fire us today. Ooh, that's cold. Welcome aboard.
This is crazy, isn't it? home.
The 13-man crew of the first dolphin expedition lived closely together for nearly 3 years. And most of their time off duty was spent in this saloon area.
Wow.
Nansen himself had a separate office beside the chart room on the half deck above, while the galley lay on the same level forward of the saloon. Heating was provided by a paraffin oven located between the two off cabins, and electric lighting was powered by the windmill on deck, with additional paraffin lamps when needed. There was little separation between officers and crew, and all the men, except the cook and his assistant, ate meals together around the saloon table. Only Nansen, Sverdrup, Scott Hansen, and Blessing had personal cabins. The two larger aft cabins, although small, were designed for 4 men each, but during the expedition, one actually slept 5. Originally, Nansen imposed a no-smoking rule everywhere under deck except in the galley, which became an attractive meeting place, as most of the crew at that time smoked pipes. This rule was discarded after Nansen himself began smoking during the first Christmas.
you off at one point in the journey. There's this whale fish and the size of him. The giant boulder starts chasing us down the corridor. You were warned me, right? Boulder comes down the corridor. Small tunnel if you want. It goes back to where you started.
Hello.
Does it smell?
No, not like the igloo.
Not like the igloo did, okay.